I'm Archie. I'm at the Bike Shed Festival this year, 2019. I've been running in the Mallee Trials this weekend, and this is my BMW R80. I'm just waiting to go out on the track for the Dirt Bike Cup. It's a shed build that I've been building over various years. It's gone through lots of disguises. You see a number of R80s, but I wanted to build something that was more of an off-road enduro type weapon, which you can ride to work on in the week and race at the weekend. So it's a ride to work race bike. Some of the features I've had done on the bike are longer travel suspension off of a KLX 650. That's a KLX front wheel. We've modified the yokes, a custom made headlight just to give it a sort of a Deja Belle feel for the sort of desert racer type thing. I've got a Brembo caliper off of a KTM 500 with braided hoses, which is working quite nice, and some high-rise Renfrew bars, which are sort of is in a state of evolution, this bike, so nothing's finished. It's a prototype. Everything's going to be eventually getting there, but it's been running really nice this weekend. The frame's been modified up here for extra strength. We've had a bar welded in there. This is a tank that I sourced off of a friend who took it to Auto Jungle for me. Really nice shape. Sort of inspired off of a Cheney JBR model. And the bag is, I've just recently got that, I was really pleased. It's an eBay find, KTM 400 ISDT, and I've got my, that's the timetable of the races today, so I'm riding a 250. I'm looking forward to that. And then you can get some tools in there, but I've gone lightweight, no tools today, not needed. And just running around the engine, very simple. Cut off the top here just to give it a cleaner line, resprayed, and then put some grid in here just to stop some dirt going in there. I've made this on the lathe so we can, it's a higher breather, so you can run through a bit of water, fill these holes up down here. It's got GS pipes on it, NGK plugs. Because we've had the longer forks put on, the centre stand needs to be lengthened so it sits up taller, better ground clearance, great for going off-road, rocks and bumps. We've got modified air filter, so just to get a bit more free-flowing air through there. And the big mod is the quick action throttle, twin cables, so I get full power. So I've got Domino, it still needs a bit of tweaking, but it's there. Great feature to have. Flip up pegs for this weekend. And as we move back towards the bike, I've got, I think it's a Kajiva seat that I've made fit. A whole custom subframe. Titanium bolts here for the shock. The shock is off of a BMW 450 enduro bike, which I also sourced, which is working really nice. We can dial it in, so if I want to go softer, a few kicks harder, and we've got rebound down here, which is really nice adjustment. Just keeps that wheel tractable. I've gone for the Anarchy tire. It was great yesterday, poor today, bit slippy, but hopefully it'll be good out on the track later. Acropovic pipe, carbon fiber guard there, which I picked up. A modified gear lever. The list goes on this bike. I could talk about it for ages. We've gone for the Odyssey battery. It's in a state of evolution, so that's it really. That's the bike for now, but it will evolve in the future. If you want to hear it, this is what it sounds like. So I've got the ignition there. Don't forget to subscribe to the Bike Shed YouTube channel. Hope you like the bike. This is my R80. It's gonna change. There's some bits that are really nice. But if anyone's got any tips for me, any future plans, what they're building, it'd be great to hear from you. Nice. Don't forget to subscribe. Subscribe.
To the Bike Shed YouTube channel.
Subscribe, well, I'm not saying it right though. Subscribe.
It's been a long weekend.
It's been a long weekend.